these fancy and expensive clothes are sold on the high streets of New York, London, Milan, and Mumbai. But you may not know that many of them are produced by small kids working under inhuman and hazardous conditions. Iftikhar has been one such child. Asif has been another. And so was Jahangir.
How can you allow child slavery to continue? Millions of children are sold and bought like animals. This is a shame for all those who believe in humanity and human rights, cultures and constitutions.
The cheated and helpless parents are left with only one hope, and that is Bachpan Bachao Andolan or Save the Childhood Movement. The activists listen to them patiently, cross-check the information, and then plan a secret raid and rescue operation. After coordinating with various government agencies, BBA activists ask the magistrate and the police to accompany them. Thousands of children are living and working in slave-like conditions, in hundreds of small factories, in these congested and crowded streets. The secret operation begins now. Wow, the children are found. This means that there was no information leak at any stage. Dozens of children were found working in cosmetic and embroidery units. The raid is conducted under the leadership of the world-renowned crusader against child slavery, Kailash Satyarthi. In the last three decades, Kailash and his organization BBA has rescued more than 78,000 children. The traumatized children don't understand what is happening. Kailash consoles them. Within no time, he builds some confidence and makes them speak. The other activists are raiding different factories. This is one where 37 children are found. They work, live, cook and sleep in the same small, suffocating, dark rooms. Their days begin and end here, as do their weeks, months and years. Now the dark tunnel of endless fear and slavery is over for these children. They come out into the light with a smile and a newfound confidence. Of course, they are free. A new life begins here. The children are taken to the police station for legal formalities. Everything is done swiftly. They must leave the place before any retaliation or attack takes place. PBA has lost two of its colleagues in the past. One was shot and another was beaten to death. The children are hungry, so the activists give them snacks and several efforts are made to comfort them. After long bureaucratic proceedings, the magistrate declares them to be bonded laborers and announces their freedom officially. The children are brought to Mukti Ashram, a transit rehabilitation center for freed child laborers. The ashram was set up by Bachpan Bachao Andolan in 1990. The name has a meaning too. Mukti means the complete liberation of a human being, and ashram means a retreat.
इन सभी बच्चों को बधुआ मजदूरी उन्मूलन कानून के अंतर्गत 20,000 रुपए का कंपनसेशन मिलेगा, जिससे इन बच्चों का आर्थिक पुनर्वास हो सकेगा और सामाजिक सुरक्षा की योजनाओं का लाभ इन सभी बच्चों के परिवारों को मिलेगा।
At the ashram, the children reclaim their lost childhood. They're happy. They can laugh freely. They can sing and they can dance. Many of you won't believe, but the truth is that most of them haven't seen an open sky for the last few months and even years. They are given footballs and cricket bats, which they have never even touched before. The process of their safe repatriation and follow-up for schooling and rehabilitation begins. After all the hardships and the long separation, the children are restored to their parents. The tears of joy in the mother's and the father's eyes cannot be explained in words. It is hard for them to believe that they are able to hold their child in their arms again.
Bachpan Bachao Andolan is committed to abolish child slavery. We want to make sure that all children enjoy fullest of their childhood and education.